you take your behind to class today?
I do be going to class.
Lunch is not a class, Shorty.
Now trigger warning is banned by Brandeis University along with the offensive phrases picnic, rule of thumb, and take a shot at it. Welcome to the Dumb Dumb News channel, dedicated to reviewing news stories from around the world. Help me trigger the YouTube algorithm by pressing the thumbs up button, subscribing to my channel, leaving a comment, and sharing with someone you think would like this content. Sources will be linked in the description, so you can read the full details yourself. Brandeis University in Waltham, Massachusetts, has warned its students and faculty against using violent language, even banning the phrase trigger warning for its association with guns. Brandeis University in Waltham has created an anti-violence resource called the Prevention, Advocacy and Resource Center, which provides information and advice to students and staff. It lists words and idioms, including picnic and rule of thumb, which it claims are violent, and suggests dreary alternatives such as outdoor eating for the former and general rule for the latter. Brandeis also disagrees with rule of thumb, which it claims comes from an old British law allowing men to beat their wives with sticks no wider than their thumb. The precise origins of the phrase are unclear, but it is meant in the sense of approximating something using the thumb rather than a specific tool. There is no evidence of a legal application to wife beating. Among the most absurd phrases that the university objects to is trigger warning, the very term which was coined to help those who might be offended by language. Brandeis suggests that instead of trigger warning, speakers should use content note or drop-in. The word trigger has connections to guns for many people. We can give the same heads up using language less connected to violence, the anti-violence group says. In addition to its page of violent language, the college has a whole section dedicated to oppressive language, which includes identity-based language, language that doesn't say what we mean, culturally appropriative language, and person-first language. Other linguistic leaps are to be found for disabled person, which is corrected to person with a disability, addict, which should be phrased person with a substance use disorder, and prostitute, where the phrase person who engages in sex work is recommended. The university provides a form where students and faculty members can submit further oppressive words to be added for consideration. Laugh out loud, you can't make this stuff up. Banning words based on meanings other than their current interpretation and based on the past that can't be proven? I thought the ultimate way to ensure against tyranny was freedom of speech. The First Amendment to the Constitution of the United States includes freedom of speech. It is sad to see that there is so much craziness happening in schools right now all across the country. That I thought schools had their hands full just teaching students and keeping them in line. I didn't know they had all this extra time to push these crazy agendas. Those are my thoughts. What are yours? Leave them in the comments below. Please share this video for education and awareness. For the Dumb Dumb News channel, I'm Dumb Dumb.